Well, hello and welcome. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the 27th Annual Dusty Film and Animation Awards. I'm Valerie Smaldone, and I am thrilled to be back once again to host this wonderful event that I've been able to do every year, so thank you for having me back. It's been quite a long year, quite a long ride for so many of you. Before we begin, can I hear some applause for the students and the instructors and the parents and the faculty and the administration of SVA? I have to thank some people who are kind enough to have me back, David and Tony Rhodes, and of course the producer of tonight's very special event, Annie Flocco. And also, yes, give it up for Annie, thank you. You'll be hearing from Annie a little bit later in the show. And thanks also to the chairman of the Film and Animation Department, who is also a filmmaker and actor in his own right. It is my pleasure to introduce you to a gentleman to kick off the 27th Annual Dusties. Please welcome Reeves Lehman.
Good evening. Give me a minute here. Good evening. Welcome to the 27th Dusty Film and Animation Festival Awards. And tonight we're here to celebrate the achievements of our graduating filmmakers and animators. Everyone in the business knows, no matter what the length of the film, it is very difficult to make a good one, whether it's fiction, documentary, animation. So having said that, I want to congratulate all the students on their accomplishments. And, of course, everyone who supported them, like their parents, of course. Their friends, the faculty, the film and animation staff, and our president, Mr. David Rhodes. I also want to acknowledge the film and animation companies that support the Dusties by giving generous grants that enable students to complete their productions. On behalf of the students, thank you so much. And you've been loyal in every year, so I'm really happy about that. I wanted to say something about the woman who just left, Valerie Smaldone. She's an incredible woman, a friend, an actress, a moderator. She's a media personality and a lovely woman, and also one of the lucky things for us is she teaches at SVA. So, Valerie, where did you go? Thank you, dear. excuse me. And there's great appreciation for the independent professional filmmakers, animators, and screenwriters who are outside of SVA, who gave their time to review the work being honored tonight. They came, they had no relationship with the students, nothing about the school other than they are friends, they come and lecture once in a while, so they gave a lot of time. And I have to say that being a judge on many film festivals around the world, it's not an easy task to look at so many productions with a critical eye and make those important decisions about what work at that particular time is deserving of to be acknowledged. And of course, I cannot be thankful enough to the presenters who are here tonight, and you're going to meet them in a moment or two, because they are part of this event and will always be remembered for coming here. I don't know any other school that does it like we do it. And therefore, I have to give really special, like Valerie did, special recognition to our Dusty producer, Annie Flocco, and her staff. They're just hardworking people. And to put this event together, which was a 3 or 4 day event, you know, it really does take hard work and organizing, and just they do a great job every year. So I can't be thankful enough to them. And Annie, I assume after tonight that you'll be almost done. You know, you have a day or two to wrap things up, whatever. And on another note, and this is a real honor for me, to have two dear friends of mine who are incredible, well-accomplished, proud alumni here tonight. It's Mr. Tom Cito, who is listed. He's done so many films, I suppose it's Jones and The Lion King and so forth, who is listed as one of the top 100 most important people in animation, you know? And a good friend. And he comes to SVA a lot, and when we go out to LA, he's a good buddy and talks to the students and so forth. So thank you, and your lovely wife, Patricia, who's the same way. You know, they actually fell in love at SVA, you know? So that was nice, right? And they're still together, so that's even nicer, right? And there's another person who he and I went to SVA together, and actually Tom as well, so the three of us came together that year, but this gentleman, Oscar winning sound man who won for Titanic, and he does most of what's his name? Quentin Tarantino's films, yes. Things. But he is revered. He's a revered and brilliant, I think, sound recordist. And these two guys are just incredible, and it's an honor to have them here tonight. And we are honoring them tonight, so that's pretty cool, you know. So, and finally, I want to leave you with this. That in all my experience, especially in acting, I have learned we are at our best in our art when we are open and vulnerable. That vulnerability never gets easier, and I can testify for that. But experience can give you confidence and make you still go forth. That is one of the reasons I believe in every filmmaker and every animator should spend some time discovering him or herself by taking an acting class. At SVA, we're very close to the acting community. Some of the students, particularly the film students, have to take an acting class. It's mandatory. And all those actors are from the actor's studio. And that's been a long relationship. So at the end of the day, a real art education is an education in yourself. The parts of you that can only discover your vulnerability and put it into your work is something that you just have to keep striving for. And don't be afraid, you know, of failure ever. Failure can make you stronger. So enjoy the night. See you later. Thank you.
Hey, well, we've got a long night ahead of us and a lot of great things coming up. Couple of things. We do have a live stream audience, so for people watching around the world, hello and thank you for joining us. Yes, and if you'll be doing any social media, please hashtag Dusty2016, hashtag Dusty2016. I'm going to be thanking our sponsors tonight throughout the ceremony because without their generous support, we could not possibly make this evening happen. So, a few of our headlining sponsors who sponsored for many years, we thank B&H Photo, SCS Agency, Able Cine, and Adorama Rental Company. Thank you. Little bit of information to all the Dusty honorees. When your name is announced and you have the honor to come up, please come up, take a photo with your presenter, and then you can say a few words. So that's it. We're going to begin with a very special award tonight. That is the Human Spirit Award. And we are delighted to welcome an actress, a film producer, director, environmentalist, and UNICEF ambassador. She is a producer whose credits include Still Alice, for which Julianne Moore won an Academy Award, and American Honey, the official selection for the Festival de Cannes this year. She is making her directorial debut this year with Freak Show, and that stars Bette Midler, Abigail Breslin, Alex Lawther, and Laverne Cox. To present the Human Spirit Award this evening, I am very honored to introduce to you Miss Trudie Styler.
Hello, everyone. Well, I'm very delighted to be here tonight to present one of this year's Dusty Awards. And I'm full of admiration for all your achievements. And I know that your time at the SVA will have prepared you well to succeed. So when I was even younger than all of you, here's the granny speech beginning. My ambition was to become an actress, although at the time my planning left quite a lot to be desired. After a heated argument about my future with my dad, I ran away from home one May evening, actually, and went off to Stratford-upon-Avon in England, the home of the Royal Shakespeare Company. I was only 17, and as an aspiring actress, it seemed like the obvious and logical place to go. I hasten to add that I had no training yet, but at least I thought I was putting myself in the right place and at the right time. Well, it took a long time to repair the rift between me and my parents after I left, but happily with time, it did get healed. And despite their doubts, I did succeed. I've never been the kind of person to let obstacles get in the way, but I have to say that I owe thanks and tributes to many, many people who've helped me on my way, and tonight I'd like to pay particular tribute to the kind lady who answered the door that night to a bawling 17-year-old teenager who just said she'd left home to become an actress at the Royal Shakespeare Theatre. I trained at one of the great British drama schools and then in repertory theatres around the country when I later became one of the leading actresses at the Royal Shakespeare Company. And at that time, I was 25 and the circle was completed. In my life and career, as I said, I've met some extraordinary people, people who believe in themselves and in what they have to offer and who never give up. These are the people who make a difference in the world, and I've tried to learn from them. There are always challenges, but challenges are a gift. They focus the mind, crystallize goals, and give us the energy to succeed. And I have a feeling that all of you who've worked so hard at what you love know what I mean. So I'm going to leave you with some words of Teddy Roosevelt, who said this very well. It's not the critic who counts. The credit belongs to the man or woman who's actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who comes short again and again because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while doing greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory or defeat. So if I can leave you with one message tonight, it's this. Never take no for an answer. Never be overcome by failure, and never lose sight of your goals. And now to the real business of the night. I am delighted to present this year's SVA Human Spirit Award. And the award will go to Philippa Ford for her film Pippa.
Wow, this is great. Thank you. I just really want to thank my crew over there. I wish I could have brought them up with me. We went on this huge adventure, and it was just the journey of a lifetime. So thank you to SVA for letting me do this amazing project. And good luck to everyone else this evening. Thank you.
Philippa, wow. Trudie Styler gave you an award. I mean, this is, I'm thrilled. I'm fatumbled myself. Thank you, Miss Trudie Styler. Give her another round of applause, please. Philippa, I have your card here, honey, with your name on it. I'll give it to you later. Don't worry. Okay. Okay. This year's Dusties continues with a relatively new award that we've started doing very recently. It recognizes our illustrious alumni. We have so many. And it's the Dusty Outstanding Alumni Awards, beginning with film. And our first alum attended SVA in the mid-70s and comes to us from a field that is a very, very important element in film, which is sound. And to present the award, we have to bring up the esteemed SVA faculty member who's worked in the film business for 50 years as a production sound mixer and teacher. Please welcome SVA's sound guru, Chris Newman. Chris, yes, you're a guru. Come on up, Chris.
Gee, her font is bigger than mine. Mark Ulino was a classmate of Reeves, and it puts a lot more, much more pressure on me to do a really decent speech and intro. I'm so honored, delighted, to be able to present this award to this alumni award to Mark, and so honored that he asked me to do it. He's a distinguished Hollywood sound mixer. He's a graduate of the SVA Film School. Mark was one of those kids who had many different kinds of gifts and talents. He was a very good director. He was a very good writer. He was a very good technician in a number of areas. He was a musician like his father, and interested in art and language and culture. He is a big picture guy and also a details guy. It's very rare to get someone who's both those things. He's one of those guys who can do just about anything. So it's particularly gratifying to me that he chose to have a career in sound. And of course, nobody knows anything about sound, so we'll just keep talking about it anyway. Mark has worked in Hollywood for almost 40 years. He's worked on over 100 movies, and he's been nominated for Oscars and BAFTA awards. He's supported unions and minorities and women, including his lovely wife, Petrushka, also his boom operator at times, throughout his career. He's worked with great passion to educate people about sound's contribution to film and to filmmaking. For the last couple of years, as if that wasn't enough, Mark has been president of not one but two organizations in Hollywood, Local 695, which is the sound local, and the Cinema Audio Society. He's a fighter, he's a teacher, he's a generous colleague. It's funny, it feels like we're presenting Mark with a Career Achievement Award. But I sense that Mark will continue to impress us in all kinds of ways for years to come. I cannot wait to see what Mark brings us next. I really can't. Let's take a look at Mark's reel. I must say, Mark, that I wish I had worked on a lot of those movies. So without any further ado, Mark Ulino. Thank you, Barry.
Ooh. Telescoping the time. I remember Reeves and several other friends of us who were freshmen at SVA in 1972. And I had the good fortune of having a long chain of mentors, including this kind gentleman, to guide me through my passions over the years. It's about the filmmaking. And I'll echo some of the sentiments made earlier today about failure cannot cope with persistence. Follow your passion, find your heart, listen to your inner voice. These are key things, and it really moves me to be appreciated tonight. But I have to throw that back and suggest that, you know, my appreciation is of equal weight, and I thank you all. Thank you very much.
Mark, you had me at Stuart Little, I have to tell you. I love that mouse. Our second Outstanding Alumni Award is for animation, and this SVA recipient has such classics as Beauty and the Beast, who framed Roger Rabbit and Shrek on his resume, among others. To present the Alumni Award for animation, please welcome a longtime SVA animation faculty member who's worked on classics like Popeye and Casper in his fabulous career. Please welcome Howard Beckerman. Howard?
I used to fly up to the stage. But people don't fly, birds do. The movies are lying. All right, so this is a very special evening for me because of the person that's getting this award is Tom Cito. Years ago, if you remember, credit titles were at the front of a film. And then somewhere by the end of the 70s, the habit had become to line them all up at the end of the movie. And I remember, and most people didn't ever, you know, when the that titles come on, they leave. But I always watch them, as probably you do. And I remember stopping into a theater to see the Disney film Hercules on a slow day. It was a weekday, and hardly anybody was in the theater. And ran through the whole film. Then the credits came on, and they ran for a long time. And at the end, the very end, James Wood, who was the actor who played the villain, his voice comes on the screen and says, "Is anybody there? Am I talking to cyberspace?" And I looked around, and sure enough, I was the only one left in the theater. And it's the first time that a film ever really spoke to me. Really. And of course, the guy came in to pick up the popcorn, so I left. But what I do very often in school, I teach a history of animation class in the amphitheater, the main building, and I very often will run a credit roll for the students to show them that not everyone makes the movie themselves. There's a lot of other people out there, not just standing around drinking coffee. There's a lot of people very active in 900 names or something. And I'll tell them, you know, there are a lot of reasons why you should read the credits, and I'll point out that maybe one day your name will be up there, and then you'll be sitting there watching it, and some guy sitting next to you is going to get up and leaving and say, "Where are you going?" You know, "My name's on there," you know, and go like that, but it's on there, you know. So, but what I like to do is, the reason I like looking at the credits, especially in animation, is to see the names of former students, and very often, I can show them the students that. And I'm always looking for the name of Tom Cito, who had a magnificent career. He's still working on things, and it was really wonderful. He was here also back in the 1970s when I began teaching animation here. And he always had wonderful interest in a lot of things. It wasn't just animation, which he was solidly interested in. He was already doing work while he was in school for little local studios. And before graduation, I believe he was working at night on the Raggedy Ann film. It was a feature film being made on 45th Street right here in Manhattan. And so he had this early beginnings. He was already involved with it. And I point out that, you know, I would say that Tom Cito was sitting approximately over there. And he wasn't sitting alone. He was sitting with a young woman, a very wonderful young woman called Patricia, who he married. You heard about that. And I have to tell you that before computer dating, SVA was the place. You know, so everybody flocked here because that's where the girls were. Anyway, so now it's the other way around. A lot of girls and boys are here too, you know. So he went out into the field. He worked locally for a while, and then he went out to Hollywood and worked for Hanna-Barbera, and working on TV films. And over the years, he worked on various TV films, about 22 different shows, all different superheroes and funny dogs and funny other characters, all those different programs, Cosby Kids, everything like that. Working around, he went to Europe, and he got involved with a very important film, Who Framed Roger Rabbit? And it was very important for his career also, because that film initiated Disney's new renaissance, another renaissance of films, and he worked on most of those, Beauty and the Beast, and The Little Mermaid, and Aladdin, and Pocahontas. And I remember visiting him out in Glendale, when the studio was temporarily in Glendale several years ago, and they were planning and working on the storyboard for Aladdin. And I'd heard about this, all the publicity was out that they were making a film called The Lion King. I knew nothing about what it was, and I asked him, what is this about? And he said very simply, somewhat, these words, it's a Disney film where Bambi meets Hamlet in Africa. And I said, oh. Yeah. And if you don't know what that means, go to, it's on Bryn Mawr, been on Broadway for 20 years, I thought. Anyway, so he worked on about 32 motion pictures, feature films, along with other short subjects and things. And he directed Osmosis Jones, which while he was connected with Warner Brothers. He actually left Disney to go to DreamWorks. He worked on the Prince of Egypt and the Shrek. He was the storyboard director on Shrek. And I asked him one time, what's the difference of working at DreamWorks with a lot of former Disney people? What's the difference of working at DreamWorks than working at Disney's? He said, well, at DreamWorks, when you're walking through the hallway, people smile at you. So that, all of those who are anxious to work in certain studios, keep this in mind. It's nice to be smiled at from time to time when you're doing all those labors. So the other thing is he also became involved with the unions in animation. And for 10 years, almost 10 years, he was the president of the Cartoonists Union, of the Animation Guild out in Hollywood, and a very effective president, and also very effective in a lot of other ways. He also wrote articles and books. He's written two very important books, among other things that he's written and contributed to. He wrote a book on the union itself, on the history of unions and animation. Animation was one of the few units in Hollywood that was not unionized initially. The actors were unionized, the musicians, the lighting guys, the cinematographers, but everybody was avoiding the animation people because they wanted to keep paying them very little money. I mean, that was important to them, to the producers anyway. So he was very effective in that, and he wrote a book, entire history of the struggle, to get an animators union. And then recently he really stepped forward and did a book. He was here signing it a couple of years ago on the history of computer animation. The name of the book escapes me at the moment. It's a moving innovation. Right, very good. Thank you. I'm really happy to be here because we had a wonderful thing. One of the things about Tom, it always amazed me, was, as I said, he was interested in a lot of things, and mostly history, and all the kind of things that can turn in you and make and come up with ideas for things. And I can see where he used it effectively in working all these films that take place at different times, different places, and it sparked his own work, definitely involved with research in that area. So I think that this gentleman really deserves the honor of the award that we're about to give him. Do we have that? Very well deserved.
Wow, this is heavy. It looks like, yeah, it's got money. Oh, cool. All right. Okay. Well, thank you. Wow. Thank you, everybody. God, I'm emotional.
Oh, dear.
Let me get my glasses. Here we go. I know, suddenly, you know, you just work, you know, day in and day out, and you look up, and suddenly you're an elder. Wow. I'm like one of the old folks now, so. Anyway, you know, actually, it's kind of funny, but one of the things Howard used to say that I say to students now was when I was a student, he would say, everybody talks about old animation. Nobody talks about new animation. I go, well, Howard, what is new animation? He goes, I don't know. I'm an old animator. That's your problem. And now I say that. I said, I can say that now. So like, you'll figure it out. I don't know. So anyway, getting down to the body. The old saying in Hollywood is, it's not what you know, it's who you know. I was the son of a Brooklyn firefighter. I never thought I'd be a Disney animator. I never thought I'd be a professor at USC. I never thought I'd be an author. I just wanted to draw cartoons. That's all that really happened, you know. And then your career happens. But really, SVA gave that to me. I mean, SVA was such an amazing place. You know, you went in and there was all these teachers, and the teachers were all professionals, and they had done all this stuff before. And you know, having teachers like Howard Beckerman and Marty Abrams and the wonderful Gil Moret and Harvey Kurtzman and Will Eisner was just like, it was just transfixing. You know, it was just so amazing to work, you know, to be under them. They taught me their skills. They taught me how to act like a professional. They gave me my first jobs, and they introduced me to the professional community here in New York. You know, what I love about, you know, Harvey Kurtzman for a minute, he's passed away now, but Harvey was the creator of Mad Magazine, and Harvey used to teach here regularly, and Harvey always liked to go after class. The class went into the night, when, you know, it was done about 8 o'clock, and then Harvey always liked to go for a beer afterwards before he got the last commuter train to Mount Vernon. And so we would sit at Connolly's, which was no longer here. It was a little bar across the street, right across the 23rd Street building. And Harvey, I think Harvey sensed in me that someday I would teach. I don't know. But he said to me, he says, my theory of teaching is, got a 15-week class, bring in 5 guest speakers. He says, pros love to talk. Students never get enough of hearing from pros. And you can sit in the back and have a cigarette. And actually, it was fun to talk about drama. I remember, Bart Midwood was my drama teacher, and he always had a cigarette in his face all the time. And, you know, he's like, use it, man. Use that anger, man. You know, so like, that was like his constant, you know, mantra, you know. But, I mean, I just learned so much from these people, and it just always kind of stuck with me. And what they taught me too is that you go as far as you dare, so why not go all the way? So I'd like to say to the class of 2016, good luck in your adventures in the real world. And you know, what you've learned the skill of animation now, and you've learned that there's a business out there beyond just beyond the confines of your own neighborhood. And you could go and do whatever you want. It really, I always tell people that success doesn't always go to the best artist and doesn't always go to the best connected or the best hustler, but it goes to the stubborn. You just got to be very tough about it. You just got to don't take no for an answer. You know, if you get critique and all, you know, work with it. You know, if you get turned down, so what? I got turned down for lots of jobs. You know, it doesn't matter. You know, what you do is that it's the 100 years war. You're in year one. You got a long way to go. Don't worry about it. When you're 50, you haven't figured it out, then you got a problem. Right now, you're good. So really, I want to thank SVA. I want to thank Reeves and David Rhodes and everybody here, you know, for giving me a career, giving me a really nice marriage, and giving me a wonderful life. And the other great thing that I learned from the studios was they'd always say, you know, productions and projects come and go, but you work with the same people. So stick close to your schoolmates. You're going to grow old with them. Your husbands and wives will come and go. These are the people you're going to know for the rest of your life. And it's true. It's true. You know? About 3 of them from my class were like, are you going to be in town? Let's get together. You know? So really, it's, you know, they're your allies. And it's not what you know. They're the ones who you know. So good luck. Okay.
Congratulations to both Tom and Mark. Both flew in from LA for this honor, so we are thrilled that you came. to both of you. Thank you. And we continue with our thank yous to sponsors who are alumni, Carlos Saldana of Bottle Cap Productions, Randall Emmett of Emmett Furla Oasis Films, Brian Singer of Bad Hat Harry Productions, and Susan Godfrey of The Productive. Thank you. So we continue with the 27th Annual Dusties, moving on now to the Women in Film and Television Award. There is this great organization called NYWFT, New York Women in Film and Television, and our next presenter is the president of the board of directors of this organization. She is an independent film producer and consultant who began her career in production on such notable films as Mississippi Burning, Bonfire of the Vanities, and A League of Their Own. Please welcome Alexis Alexanian. Alexis?
Thank you. I'm very thrilled to be here today, and I'm still soaking in all of the amazing work that Tom and Mark have done, and I can't help but be kind of overwhelmed because I'm in, I forget what year you said, Tom, if you don't know what you're doing, you're in big trouble, but I'm in year 30. I think it's about the work, right? It's just about, as somebody very prolific said to me once, you just keep doing what you're doing, and one day you wake up and you have this beautiful spider web or something like that, you know, Anyway, I'm the president of New York Women in Film and Television, and I'm here to talk to you a little bit about what we do. For over 35 years, New York Women in Film and Television has advocated for the rights of women in film and television before there was digital media. Now we add digital media. We are a 2,000-member organization of women and men, professionals here in New York City. We program over 50 programs a year, professional development seminars, training sessions, screenings, and Q&As. We celebrate women's work. We have two major events a year, the Muse Awards, where we honor women from both sides of the camera, and Designing Women, which is coming up soon, where we honor women in hair, makeup, and costume design. We provide a very well-needed forum for women at various stages of their career. So, graduates, remember us, come back and think of us. We're here for you, and we'll help you along the way. We have had a long-standing relationship with SVA, Reeves, Lehman, thank you, and Annie Flocco. We have a wonderful sort of collaboration throughout the year, and this is my favorite part of the year with you guys, because we get to give a prize, a $2,500 prize to a woman whose work we think is exemplary in the graduating class. And I mean, it's very hard to choose because all of you are so talented. I find this a very, very inspiring day. As crusty as I am, as I've got a few gray hairs and I think, I sit here and I look at your work and I'm just like amazed. I am really amazed. So I wish you all of the best. And in the meantime, I would love to give this prize to, is there a drum roll here? No. Maya Kozia.
Such an honor to receive this award. There's so many talented filmmakers in this room, and I can't believe this. Thank you so much. As a woman of color, this really means a lot to me. Shooting this film was a very challenging process. I shot this film entirely in a car, and everything went wrong. The car stopped working. The equipment truck almost rolled off the hill. My actor's wallet got stolen. but thank you so much to the crew that really stuck through it to the end. Thank you so much, Jackson, Brian, JT, you guys mean the world to me. And to my thesis advisor, Chris Newman, and to Anne Newman for really believing in me and believing in the story. Thank you so much. And yeah, thank you.
Congratulations, and thank you, Alexis. And thank you also to the Criterion Collection, Audio Network, Anthology Film Archives, and the Law Office of Robert Siegel. The 27th Annual Dusty Awards continues as we also continue with our live stream, along with the IFP Award presented by Zach Mandinac, Program Manager and Producer of the Independent Filmmaker Project. Zach has worked for the Hamptons International Film Festival and the Tribeca Film Festival as well. Please welcome Zach Mandinac.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you to SVA for having us here. We've been happy at IFP to give out this award. For those of you who don't know, I can talk a little bit about IFP, who we are, and what we do. IFP has been around for quite a long time, since the late 70s. We're among the oldest and largest nonprofits in the country dedicated to independent film. And have been thrilled over the years to support many, many filmmakers, including many SVA alums. And so I look forward to seeing many of your work over the course of these coming years. So congratulations to all of the graduating filmmakers. And so this award that we give out comes with some great perks. So it provides the winner with a free membership to IFP, which among many things, it comes with the membership program at IFP. You get free screenings and events, but perhaps most important of all is you're able to apply to the many IFP programs that we offer around the year, lab programs for feature-length films and short episodic content in post-production, and our flagship program, Independent Film Week, in which we select around 140 projects in various stages of development, production, post-production, to come here to New York to take meetings with various members of the industry. So it's a great prize that we're very happy to offer each year at the Dusties. And I'm happy to present this year's IFP Award to two filmmakers, Enrico Granato and Luigi Rossi.
Thank you very much for this recognition. I am very happy to be here to share this prize with Enrico. Come along. And yeah, we're thrilled to be here.
Thank you so much, and thanks to Luigi for giving me this opportunity to shoot this movie, and thanks to everyone who worked on it. Thank you.
Congratulations, guys, and thank you, Zach. And thank you to Photo Care, Nice Shoes Creative Studio, Asia Video Systems, and Digit Audio. So a film without sound is really a very different storytelling experience completely. And so in the genre of sound, we want to honor an SVA student with a Gotham Sound Grant. And I'd like to welcome back our SVA expert in sound, Chris Newman has worked on more than 85 features and has won Oscars for The Exorcist, Amadeus, and The English Patient. Recently received the Career Achievement Award from the Cinema Audio Society. Welcome back, Chris Newman. Come on, Chris. You're still a guru. You're still a guru. It's okay. Come on up.
Listen, in the past, I've done some kind of memorializing about people who've passed, friends, colleagues, etc. And there are always people. And the older one gets, there are always many. But this year, I decided not to be bothered with that. I do want to do a shout out to Manny Kirchheimer, who just won a Guggenheim. And for that, he's the best kept secret in the school. And maybe he's not a secret. I don't know about sound. Nobody knows anything about sound. But they insist on giving this award. The Gotham Sound Grant, without any further ado, goes to Ashley Avila. Ash, where are you? Oh, you are there.
See anything. Four years flew by, and I'm so honored to have met and worked with, and I'm able to call you guys friends and coworkers. So best of luck to everyone tonight. Thank you.
Ashley, you were my teaching assistant. I appreciate the work you did. Thank you so much, and congratulations. Fantastic. I love sound. I teach voiceover, so sound is my life. So I'm very grateful for all the sound people here. Congratulations once again. We move on to the Outstanding Achievement in Character Animation and Outstanding Achievement in Animation Production Design. Our presenter just received a special alumni award himself, and a special note for Tom Cito was featured in the PBS documentary, Walt Disney. Welcome back, Tom Cito. Come on back, Tom. We're putting you to work today, right?
Okay, cool. Animo, animas, animat, to give life. To bring life. Animation is one of the oldest ways of making film. It's literally handmade film. It's, you know, art projected 24 frames a second. Yet, despite its pedigree, with the digital revolution in the last 25 years, animation has moved into the center of the way we experience media today. I mean, everything is dependent on animation now. You know, visual effects. I mean, you know, how much of Gravity was live action? This much, you know, like that. You know, how much of Avatar was animation? It was like about 5 minutes of Sigourney Weaver smoking cigarettes in a spaceship. You know, it's like, you know, this is not green, blue people and flying dragons running around. It's the same technique as what made, you know, Bart Simpson or Bugs Bunny move around. So really, people that are working in animation and all, you know, there's so many other branches of the film business, you know, things like online and virtual reality and stuff like that is all starting to become dependent on animation. So you're really sort of uniquely centered into, launching yourself into a career in modern media. And it's going to be very interesting to see what you do in the next coming years.
So anyway, let's get down to the goodies here. So here are the honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Character Animation.
The honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Character Animation are Stefano Romano, Lovemaking Saves the World.
Bam, boom, bam. Go check for pigs. Mm-hmm. We'll take care of the party.
Xuan Ho and Silver Paul, Mousy and the Order of the Golden Sun. Montana Hall, Monster. Ivan Vironkek, Night Shadows.
And the Dusty goes to Montana Hall from Monster.
This is nerve-wracking. Oh my gosh. I really want to thank my Nana and Papa, Mom, Dad, and Jack for supporting me in following my dreams. Thank you. And to the entire SVA Anna fam, thank you so much for just being there, listening to me talk about my ideas and supporting me. And Mark, Sam, Gabby, this would not be possible without you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Okay. All right. Now, here are the honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Animation Production Design.
The honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Animation Production Design are Joseph Altadonna, Berg Out. Ivan Vironkek, Night Shadows. Christina Martin, Sprigs and Parsley in Coffee Table. Xuan Ho and Silver Paul, Mousy and the Order of the Golden Sun.
Okay. And the Dusty goes to Ivan Viranchuk. For Night Shadows, Slava, Slava, Chip.
Mm-hmm.
evening, everybody. It's an honor for me to receive this award from Team Soto. I'm sorry, Team Cito. It's been a very long and difficult production year, but it was also the most creative time in my life. I'd like to thank my composer, Mark Markovsky, for his amazing music scores to our film, but Amy Rivlin, who I consider a true co-creator of Night Shadows, for her contribution to the story, visual development, and directing. I also would like to thank all my friends at SVA, and back home in Minsk, my family, and a very special thanks to my aunt Olga, who is here tonight to support me. Thank you.
Congratulations. Tom, is this yours, these glasses? Okay. So we continue with our thanks to Nickelodeon, Toon Boom Animation, Blue Sky Studios, and DaVinci Artist Supply. Thank you very much for your support. And we continue with the 27th annual Dusty's to a special jury award for comedy and animation this year, something special, and the award for outstanding animated film. So to present these two awards, our next presenter was a director of the critically acclaimed Kung Fu Panda, and is a two-time Academy Award nominated director of the first ever animated feature film adaptation of the wonderful classic The Little Prince. Look for it soon. Please welcome Mark Osborne.
Hi, thanks so much. Thanks, it's really nice to be here. And I just wanna start by congratulating everybody who made a film. Can we hear it for everybody who finished a film? It's not easy. It is never easy. And it's really great to be able to give awards. I mean, this is incredible that SVA does this, and I'm really thrilled to be able to be a part of it. So, congratulating everybody who made a film, and I congratulate everybody who supported, and to the parents who supported all these artists, and it's really incredible, and you can't do it without support, and you can't do it by yourself. So I really want to thank also everybody else, that helped to make these films. You guys all should get a round of applause as well. And the one thing that I'll just say, and just try to give a little bit of wisdom, there's been a lot of great advice tonight, and I think short films are such an incredible way to not only find yourself as a filmmaker, but to express to the world who you are as an artist, and especially at this stage, as you're sort of entering out into the world, it is so important for you, even if you don't win tonight, send your films out to all the festivals you can. Increase the odds that your film will get seen. Really, that is a really important part of doing the work of making a film, is making sure you can find your audience. And I really hope that you'll all find audiences and that it'll really help you, and you never know where one project will take you. So my short film that I did when I was at CalArts, I thought it was a disaster, and it won prizes at festivals, and there's a lot of festivals out there, but that film got noticed by Weird Al Yankovic. He asked me to make a music video. It got nominated for a Grammy. Then someone asked me if I wanted to do a short, and that got nominated for an Academy Award, and it just kind of keeps on rolling. So best of luck to you all, and keep making shorts, and I'm going to give the special jury prize for comedy and animation to Christina Martin for Sprigs and Parsley in Coffee Table.
The special jury award for comedy and animation goes to Christina Martin, Sprigs and Parsley in Coffee Table.
I can't. My foot was so sweaty. I'm so sorry. Whoa. Okay. So, a lot of people to thank. My mom, Anne Margaret, and my dad, Omar. They're putting me through this school, so a lot of money. mi abuela y abuelo, Miraida Valdivia y Marano Valdivia. Love them. They helped me get to school. They would commuting and everything. I want to say, if any of you are like jealous that you don't know any cool people or anything like that, I want to thank the coolest people I've ever met, which is my friends at SVA. They're seriously the coolest people I know. So I also want to thank my little brother Peter Martin, for doing sound for my film, the sound effects. It was crazy. He had a kidney stone at one point, and he still pulled through. And I want to thank my boyfriend, Jesse Lux, who helped me with sound editing, and he's watching the live stream right now. Hey, I hope you finished your essay. So anyway, thank you so much. And yeah.
All right, and next, we're going to show the honorees for Outstanding Animated Film.
The honorees for Outstanding Animated Film are Montana Hall, Monster. Christina Martin, Sprigs and Parsley in Coffee Table.
Why do we even need a coffee table this early in the morning? Woo! I think Sam should have checked up with me. Hey!
Xuan Ho and Silver Paul, Mousy and the Order of the Golden Sun. Ivan Vironkek, Night Shadows.
And the Dusty goes to Xuan Ho and Silver Paul for Music and the Order of the Golden Sun.
Hi, this is really cool. Thank you for the award. Yeah. Well, I mean, my family is here. I love them, and I wouldn't be here without them. And I love you, Mom, Grandma, here in the back. All the friends and family, animation crew. Thank you.
Yeah, I want to thank my parents. They flew all the way from Taiwan to New York for my graduation. Yeah, they're sitting right there. Yeah, I wouldn't have made it if they didn't like sponsor me. Yeah, it's very expensive, especially for international students to attend a school in New York. And they tried their best so I can fulfill my dreams. And I want to thank my advisors and the people who helped along the way, including alumni Dana Terrace and the Rauch brothers, and also Mark, Sam, and Gabby for being such amazing staff. And thank the 2016 animation department people. That's right there. Thank you all.
Also, I just want to apologize if I seem off-puttish. It's just, I'm kind of nervous, that's all. Yeah. But I do appreciate this. This does mean a lot. Thank you, and I'll cherish it.
Congratulations. Thank you, Mark, for presenting. And special thank yous to Cartoon Network, Animation Magazine, Asifa East, Cartoona, and Titmouse. Our next category is screenwriting, and our presenter is an Oscar-winning film and TV writer who co-wrote Spotlight, which just recently won the Academy Award for Best Original Screenplay. He's working on a musical biopic about Leonard Bernstein, Martin Scorsese is attached to direct. And some fun facts about this gentleman: he has a degree from Yale in math and economics, a law degree, and an MBA from Harvard. Too bad he's an underachiever. To present the Dusty for Outstanding Achievement in Screenwriting, please welcome Josh Singer. Josh?
Thank you. I keep trying to get people out west to forget that I have a law degree. It's really great stuff, and it's really an honor to be here. The first screenplay I ever wrote was terrible. It was something I showed to two people. I quickly realized it was terrible, and I put it in my desk drawer. The second screenplay I wrote was a romantic comedy, which was pretty good, but it wasn't funny at all, because I'm not really all that funny. And I showed that to 7 or 8 people, then realized, again, not funny at all, and buried that in my desk drawer. The third screenplay I wrote, I tried to work a little harder on. I spent about 2 years doing research. It was a historical piece, and I wrote a 40-page treatment, then a 45-page treatment. And I was 30 pages into the script when I found out that Steven Spielberg was doing a movie on the exact same topic in the exact same era. I talked to some of my friends in the film industry, and they said, well, these things generally don't get made. Keep writing, you need a spec anyway. And I did, and fortunately, Mr. Spielberg didn't make his movie. And when I finished mine, we got it over DreamWorks, and they bought it so it could go into Mr. Spielberg's desk drawer. But they did hire me to write a movie which became The Fifth Estate, which about 3 people saw. No, really. The movie budget was about $26 million, and we made about 8 at the box office. You can check the Rotten Tomatoes scores. They're about 37. No lie. But that script actually is what got Tom McCarthy to hire me to write Spotlight with him. So I guess I sort of see screenwriting as a series of failures, and hopefully if you fail enough, you start to fail a little less. So I'd like to congratulate all of the young filmmakers who clearly are failing a little less already. It's frustrating there's no pizzazz to announcing the honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Screenwriting. Maybe I should sing them or something. Congratulations to these 3 terrific honorees: Evan DiCarlo for Marry Me on Mulberry Mountain, Tyler Nolan for Edge of the Crater, and Sierra Ritz for Vacillate, Oscillate. And the Dusty goes to Evan DiCarlo for Marry Me on Mulberry Mountain.
I'm going to get the special thanks out of the way first. A very special thanks to Sierra Kelly, Jake Kotov, Joan Brooker. Joan, if you're here, I love you. The magnanimous Gary Richards, Julian Schlussberg, and last but not least, my parents, who have not only nourished my wallet, but my imagination, as cheesy as that sounds. And I'd like if everyone, alumni, students, parents, everybody here tonight, could just take a moment and think about the people who helped you get where you are today. Whether they're here with you or in heaven watching, if you could just take 5 seconds, I'll watch the clock, and just be thankful for them. Because they are proud of you. Thank you so much.
That was really beautiful. Thank you for that. And thank you, Josh. And thank you to SVA Campus Store, Final Draft, and WGA East. So when you want to make a film, if you don't have an editor, you just have just disjointed pieces of film with no narrative. It is most important to award the Outstanding Achievement in Editing. And to present this award, a feature film, documentary, TV, and commercial editor who's cut several films with Academy Award winner Barry Levinson. His doc credits include James Toback's Tyson and Seduced and Abandoned, among others. To present the award for Outstanding Achievement in Editing, please welcome an SVA grad, Aaron Yanis. Aaron?
Hello, hello. It's a pleasure to be back here. 15 years ago, I was a student in the audience waiting to hear if I was going to win Best Director or Best Film, and I got a nominee for Best Editing, and I didn't win, but that's okay. Because it sparked, amongst other things, a lot of the teachers I had here also, it sparked my interest in editing, and a couple years later, I was edit room assistant, and the editor was kind enough to watch my short film, and he said, the cuts are great, it's really stylish, the rhythm's great, he said, but I didn't understand the story, and that's always stuck with me, that it's all about the storytelling and getting it across, and everything else comes after that. So, I was thinking on the way here and in the past couple weeks what I would have liked to have heard when I was here. So I was thinking, the best advice I could say is maybe just, when I finished school, I just said yes to everything because you don't know who you'll meet or what it's going to lead to. And I don't know, that worked for me, so that's the best thing I can say. And then the other thing I could just steal from Martin Scorsese when he was asked about, the most important thing to becoming a filmmaker, and his one-word answer was just tenacity. So just stick with it, I would add kindness to that too, because I think it's, you want to work with pleasant people, and those are the people that will recommend you for other things. So without further ado, here are the honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Editing.
The honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Editing are Aaron DeWitt and Tobias Belliard, Apocalypse Mambo.
Watch where you're going!
Vai, vai, testa di cazzo!
Cool bitch!
Vai, testa di cazzo, vai!
Lucas Ween Kim, Rubaru.
Darius Zulkefli, Kun Fayakun.
Now you can choose to believe that this is all part of a cosmic plan, and you, Henry, are one of the rarest creatures to experience it. Mind playing tricks on you in your vegetative, medicated state.
Personally, I think that's very dull.
And the Dusty goes to Aaron DeWitt and Tobias Belliard for Apocalypse Mambo.
Picture first. The picture goes outside. Okay. Man. Oh my God. I don't know what to say. This is awesome. Thank you. Thank you to SVA. Thank you to my family and my friends at SVA. Thank you to Ed Bose. Thank you to Aaron for making sense of this movie with me, trying to figure out what this movie is. And I guess we figured it out. But yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much to everyone and everything that Tobias said again, and my dad's here somewhere, hopefully. Yes, hello. He made it to the theater. Okay. Thank you so much. Editing is, I love editing, and if you want to be an editor, go to Camille, go to Tien, go to Chris in the Pro Tools office and just get a job there and learn. That's what I'm doing, trying to just learn. So thank you to everyone and all you guys at SVA, just all my friends and everyone. Just thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, and congratulations. Congratulations, you guys. Don't forget, if you're doing social media, hashtag Dusty2016. And once again, welcome to our live stream audience around the world. Thank you also to AJA Video, City Lighting and Grip, Panavision, Schemflug, and Gotham Sound for your support. So we move on to cinematography, and another SVA grad who began his career working on Marathon and Sound Barrier. He shot White Girl, a feature that was a hit at Sundance this year. Please welcome the cinematographer on Danny McBride's new HBO show, Vice Principals, Michael Simmons. Michael?
First, I'd like to thank the 2016 class at SVA. I graduated here 16 years ago, and I remember it fondly. And a lot's changed. My love of cinema has not changed whatsoever. But one other thing hasn't changed. I'm still upset I didn't win a Dusty. And I will say, I have been nominated for many things and lost them and had no problem with it. But the Dusty bit hard. So those of you who do not win tonight, I understand how it feels. But because it's very special, to be honest, in being admired by your peers and cherishing your work and stuff like that. So congratulations to you all, and let's check out the honorees' work. Thanks.
The honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Cinematography are Brandon Yoon, Llorona. Anthony Corella, Siskon. Brandon Yoon, Apocalypse Mambo.
Мама страшная, боюсь, уползаю, не вернусь.
Please say Michael Simmons. Please say Michael Simmons. All right, it's going to Anthony for Sky Sun. Sky. Yes.
I really don't want to do this. All right, well. Well, I just got to thank my parents, because none of this is possible without them, and my friends, and my crew. Like, that's most important, or it's all important, I don't know. and my girlfriend and my advisor, Dan Georgievich. Yeah, thank you.
Well, thank you, Michael, and congratulations as well. And thank you to the International Cinematographers Guild Local 600 and Motion Picture Studio Mechanics Local 52. Give our unions a nice round of applause, yes. On to our next category. Presenting the Outstanding Achievement in Directing Award is an SVA grad and writer-director and editor of award-winning horror films in that genre, The House of the Devil, The Innkeepers, and The Sacrament. And his latest film will be released this fall. Look for The Valley of Violence. It's actually a Western, a horror Western, I'm guessing, I'm thinking. It stars Ethan Hawke and John Travolta. So please join me in welcoming Ty West.
A lot of really smart things have been said, so I will hopefully not bring it down too far this late in the day. It's a great privilege to be here as an alumni, so this is very cool, so thank you for having me. I don't remember who presented the Dusties for directing the year that I was here, but like Mike, I also didn't win, and I remember that. but, so to all the winners tonight, you know, this is a great night. This is a... This should give you a great boost of confidence that is often needed in the traumatic experience of making movies. So use this to know that you are on the right track and to keep doing what you're doing so that we can see the world through your eyes, because that is what directing is all about. And though to the, everyone who doesn't win, you just have to do the same thing, because that's just the way it goes. So. And this is a wonderful celebration. And you guys have done so much great work, and I'm sure it's what's cool about film school is that people actually appreciate the work that you do, and then they stop appreciating it, and they just get very frustrated with you. So this is a really wonderful environment. Being here, it's a very safe environment, and I hope that you got a lot out of that, because tomorrow, you're not student filmmakers anymore, you're just filmmakers. So tomorrow, you just have to do what you will with that. And I suggest you all go and keep making movies, because movies are very cool. And I wish you all the best of luck. So the honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Directing are...
The honorees for Outstanding Achievement in Directing are... Marcelo Galán, Llorona.
¿Qué hacemos?
Ya sé.
Maya Cogier, Short Drop.
I'm gonna tell you something, right? Look, I say I'm sorry. Shanice, we good?
Tantan, we was never good, so hold your mother cunts.
Okay, look, we almost on top of the hill. And you have nothing to say again, eh? Nothing.
Aurora Allange, Cis Khan.
I
Kishan Savjani, Rubaru.
And the Dusty goes to Kishan Savjani for everybody.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you, Ty. We continue to thank our sponsors tonight, Technicolor Postworks New York, Seed and Spark, and Ari Rental. The cavalcade of outstanding, talented presenters continues as we move on to outstanding documentary. She's a three-time Emmy and Peabody Award-winning filmmaker. Her latest documentary, The Black Panthers, Vanguard of the Revolution, premiered at Sundance and aired on PBS to record-breaking ratings. She directed the documentary Jesse Owens, snagging an Emmy for Outstanding Research. To present the honoree for Outstanding Documentary, please welcome Lorenz Grant.
Good evening. It's very exciting to be here. I'm very thrilled to be invited. It's very amazing to be on this side of things. When you're in the trenches, you feel like you're you, but like you say, we graduate. I want to thank SVA for inviting me and Reeves. I actually taught advanced documentary workshop for a couple years here at SVA at the very popular time frame of Monday morning at 9 a.m. So I felt that that was a good metaphor for the students and for the industry. I did allow cappuccino, at least, because you do need to be awake, and you do need to have sustenance for your class and for this industry. It is not for the faint at heart, the weak's need, the weak stomach, the weak constitution. I've tried to impart all kinds of horror stories on them, and they still were, wanted to do this. And I think the most exciting thing about this industry is it doesn't matter your path. I didn't study film. I studied journalism. I lived and worked in Latin America. But those stories and that prepares you for what people think is this glamorous business. And some of the glamorous things that you'll encounter are, when your plan A and B are lost to a hurricane and you still have to shoot. You have walking pneumonia. You have an allergy attack, like someone, your shoe falls off. Your canoe won't row because it's too heavy with your clothes and your equipment, and it's gonna be sundown soon and you better start filming because you have to make your deadline. So that's the reality. That's this quote unquote glamour. But maybe one thing I will say to you all is pick your battles because you're going to need your energy and your strength to fight for your film. So right now I'd like to present the clip, correct? Of the nominees.
The honorees for Outstanding Documentary are Juana Hodari, Tomasa. Taylor Russo, Griffin. Courtney Jamal, Mission and Ocean.
I have zero skills. The only thing I can do is drive. I would say I was the best cab driver in the city of San Francisco. And the proof is I used to get a speeding ticket every week. It got to the point whereby I used to go to traffic court almost every week.
You know, I had, you know, like many, many failures in my life and had many, many successes as well. And I'm very fortunate at this moment, I have more successes than failures.
How exciting. Okay, so now the winner is Juana Hodori for Tomasa.
Hello. It has been a really long journey for me, and there are so many people to thank. First of all, my 15 family members who flew in from Argentina. Of course, my main collaborators, who are my DP, Noelia de Mena, who also flew in. Hola. And my two editors, who bear with me and my craziness every day of the week, Saturday and Sunday included, Erin DeWitt and Marcelo Galan. My two great advisors, Joan Brooker and Mary Lee Grisanti, and my mentor, Amr Sinha. Thank you for making me tap onto my memories to do this movie. I don't know, it's been so much work, so it's nice to have recognition, and it's great to be competing against other great films. And anyways, thank you. And to my mother, esta película es para vos.
Well, we're coming to the end of the show, and I have a couple more thanks. Barbizon Lighting Company, Movie Magic, and Indiegogo, thank you for your support. As you know, the final category of the evening is the honoree for Best Film, and for this, we're going to do something a little bit different this year. I'm going to turn over the podium and stage to the woman who's put her heart and incredible talents into the Dusty Film and Animation Festival and the Dusty Awards each and every year. To say a few words and introduce the presenter for Outstanding Film, please welcome director, producer, and the woman who makes this all happen, Miss Annie Flocco.
Thank you, Valerie. I'm very excited to introduce our final presenter and award, and I know you're all very excited as well to hear who that is. But first, I just have to say, Mark and Tom, your work is so truly inspiring, and it is such an inspiration to all of our students, and I think to all of us. So I just want to acknowledge that again, because it's really just amazing. We've said a lot of thank yous tonight, but I truly believe that you can never say thank you enough. So I'd like to express my gratitude to each and every one of you in this room, because in some way you have all contributed to all that we celebrate tonight. And as the head of the festival, I'm going to just do a really broad, quick sweep of thank yous. So thank you to our amazing presenters. We're so thrilled to have you here. To our incredible sponsors who are so generous, our talented judges, the SVA community because you care so much and give so much to all of our students. I also would like to thank the family and friends that are here, and as you've heard, so many of them have come from so far to celebrate tonight. I'd also want to give a shout out to Ralph Applebaum because he was my MVP, as I called him this year, in helping to get us some amazing presenters. So thank you, Ralph, wherever you are. I'd like to thank Valerie, who always does such an incredibly beautiful job. So thank you, Valerie. And I'm going to give a shout out to our Dusty girl, who's also my niece. And last, I just want to say thank you to all of our film and animation students. You are so wonderful, and it brings me such joy. We work so hard, and then to be here and see your films on the big screen with you, and even more so, the big, big smiles on your faces, that makes it all worth it. So I just want to say congratulations. I am so proud of all of you, and so honored to be a part of this community. So thank you. And now I am thrilled to introduce a very talented filmmaker whose directing credits include Limitless, the critically acclaimed, The Illusionist, and 2014 hit Divergent, and most recently, the new Showtime hit Billions. So to present our Outstanding Film Award and final award, please welcome Neil Berger.
I'm very happy to be here. It's actually incredibly impressive to see the community at SVA, and I can say a lot of things, but I can say keep that community around you, and you'll need them. Filmmaking is a community effort, and we rely on each other. And to the directors out there, I'm a director, and as a director, you can forget how important that community is, and my advice to you is don't forget that community. It's an exciting time to be a filmmaker right now for a lot of reasons, and I'm happy for you filmmakers. And I think one of those reasons to me is that I think that the fundamental way we tell our stories is actually going to radically change, and is changing already. I'm not talking about binge watching, though that may be part of it. I'm talking about really narrative itself. If you watch a 15-year-old kid on Snapchat or Instagram or whatever, you'll see their sense of storytelling is completely different. They're wired differently. They take in narrative differently. They construct it differently. And it's not just 15-year-olds. We're all wired a little differently at this point. A purist would say that's what's killing traditional filmmaking, and maybe it is, but to me, storytelling is essential to our lives, and it'll continue to be. And I'm just betting it's going to come in a different form, and that's not a bad thing. What's it going to look like? I have no idea. But I do have some thoughts about it, and in a way, one of those thoughts is that I think you filmmakers, you young filmmakers, have the answer already. Or if you don't now, you're in a great position to stumble onto it. How does that happen? It's difficult to predict. All you can do as filmmakers really is just keep doing your own work. Keep making things. Narratively, do whatever you need to do to tell your story. Push the form. Be bold. Take risks. Don't be afraid to fail big time. And then keep on going. Keep experimenting. What haven't we seen before? What's new? And also true to you. You can't force or fake it. All you can do and should be doing is be honest in your own work. And if you are honest, if you're pushing and if you're taking risks, then your own true voice will emerge. And maybe it already has, based on the work that I've seen tonight. And if it has, if so, then you know you can create something truly fresh and new and perhaps meaningful. And that's really what my point here is. To remind you that what you are doing is truly meaningful. It's part of a larger cultural conversation. As I said, I think something's happening, something's changing, something's in the air. And each thing you make, starting now, will be a step that contributes to that new culture, to that new world. God knows we need some changes in the world. And so you're on the cusp of something. Your culture is being born. And what's reassuring is that you all have the talent and the power to make it great. So that's a tall order. And in the meantime, here are the honorees for Outstanding Film.
The honorees for Outstanding Film are Kishan Safjani, Rubaru.
I said it. When you don't fit the part, that means you don't fit the part. Now get out!
Aurora Allange, Siskon.
Jag pratar om vad jag vill, okej?
Nej, det får du inte. Du är inte jävla dum i huvudet.
Enrico Granato and Luigi Rossi, L'Appetito Venduto.
All right, and the dusty goes to Aurora Allange for Siskon.
Thank you so much, SVA, first of all. I can't see anything. Thank you so much to SVA and all the teachers I've had here. Thank you so much to Chris. I can't see you. I don't know where you are. There you are. Chris, my lovely advisor, my mentor, my friend, first helping me throughout my 4 years here. To Mary Lee, my other advisor, to my cast and crew for their incredibly amazing work on this film. To my mom, who's in the audience, to my wonderful friends, to everyone who helped make this film happen, to Quentin, my editor, you're the man, I don't know where you are, you're the best, to my brother and my father who are watching back home in Sweden, I love you so much, thank you so much, to anyone I've forgotten, thank you, thank you.
Well, congratulations. Thank you, Neil. And we come to the end of yet another Dusty. A few more acknowledgments. Thank you to Rota 6. They did the opening video and the honoree reels as well. Quinn Florist, the floral arrangements, Caitlin McInerney on stage. And congratulations to all the winners, all the students, all the filmmakers who've been here tonight. The folks up in the booth, thank you here at SVA Theater. And as it was so well said tonight, you are no longer student filmmakers, you are now filmmakers. Congratulations. Enjoy. Thank you so much. Have a great evening.
To present this award to, this alumni award to Mark. And so honored that he asked me to do it. He's a distinguished Hollywood sound mixer. He's a graduate of the SVA Film School. Mark was one of those kids who had many different kinds of gifts and talents. He was a very good director. He was a very good writer. He was a very good technician in a number of areas. He was a musician like his father and interested in art and language and culture. He is a big picture guy and also a details guy. It's very rare to get someone who's both those things. He's one of those guys who can do just about anything. So it's particularly gratifying to me that he chose to have a career in sound. And of course, nobody knows anything about sound, so we'll just keep talking about it anyway. Mark has worked in Hollywood for almost 40 years. He's worked on over 100 movies, and he's been nominated for Oscars and BAFTA awards. He's supported unions and minorities and women, including his lovely wife, Petrushka, also his boom operator at times, throughout his career. He's worked with great passion to educate people about sound's contribution to film and to filmmaking. For the last couple of years, as if that wasn't enough, Mark has been president of not one but two organizations in Hollywood, Local 695, which is the sound local, and the Cinema Audio Society. He's a fighter, he's a teacher, he's a generous colleague. It's funny, it feels like we're presenting Mark with a Career Achievement Award. But I sense that Mark will continue to impress us in all kinds of ways for years to come. I cannot wait to see what Mark brings us next. I really can't. Let's take a look at Mark's reel. I must say, Mark, that I wish I had worked on a lot of those movies. So.
Well, hello and welcome. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the 27th Annual Dusty Film and Animation Awards. I'm Valerie Smaldone, and I am thrilled to be back once again to host this wonderful event that I've been able to do every year, so thank you for having me back. It's been quite a long year, quite a long ride for so many of you. Before we begin, can I hear some applause for the students and the instructors and the parents and the faculty and the administration of SVA? I have to thank some people who are kind enough to have me back, David and Tony Rhodes, and of course the producer of tonight's very special event, Annie Flocco. And also, yes, give it up for Annie, thank you. You'll be hearing from Annie a little bit later in the show. And thanks also to the chairman of the Film and Animation Department, who is also a filmmaker and actor in his own right. It is my pleasure to introduce you to a gentleman to kick off the 27th annual Dusties. Please welcome Reeves Lehman.
Good evening. Give me a minute here. Good evening. Welcome to the 27th Dusty Film and Animation Festival Awards. And tonight we're here to celebrate the achievements of our graduating filmmakers and animators. Everyone in the business knows, no matter what the length of the film, it is very difficult to make a good one, whether it's fiction, documentary, animation. So having said that, I want to congratulate all the students on their accomplishments. And, of course, everyone who supported them, like their parents, of course. Their friends, the faculty, the film and animation staff, and our president, Mr. David Rhodes. I also want to acknowledge the film and animation companies that support the Dusties by giving generous grants that enable students to complete their productions. On behalf of the students, thank you so much. And you've been loyal in every year, so I'm really happy about that. I wanted to say something about the woman who just left, Valerie Smaldone. She's an incredible woman, a friend, an actress, a moderator. She's a media personality and a lovely woman. And also, one of the lucky things for us is she teaches at SVA. So, Valerie, where'd you go? Thank you, dear. So. excuse me. And there's great appreciation for the independent professional filmmakers, animators, and screenwriters who are outside of SVA, who gave their time to review the work being honored tonight. They came, they had no relationship with the students, nothing about the school other than they are friends, they come and lecture once in a while, so they gave a lot of time. And I have to say that being a judge on many film festivals around the world, it's not an easy task to look at so many productions with a critical eye and make those important decisions about what work at that particular time is deserving of to be acknowledged. And of course, I cannot be thankful enough to the presenters who are here tonight, and you're going to meet them in a moment or two. Because they are part of this event and will always be remembered. Thank you.
Okay, well, we've got a long night ahead of us and a lot of great things coming up. A couple of things, we do have a live stream audience, so for people watching around the world, hello and thank you for joining us. Yes, and if you'll be doing any social media, please hashtag Dusty2016, hashtag Dusty2016. I'm going to be thanking our sponsors tonight throughout the ceremony because without their generous support, we could not possibly make this evening happen. So a few of our headlining sponsors who've sponsored for many years, we thank B&H Photo, SCS Agency, Able Cine, and Adorama Rental Company. Thank you. Little bit of information to all the Dusty honorees. When your name is announced and you have the honor to come up, please come up, take a photo with your presenter, and then you can say a few words. So that's it. We're going to begin with a very special award tonight. That is the Human Spirit Award. And we are delighted to welcome an actress, a film producer, director, environmentalist, and UNICEF ambassador. She is a producer whose credits include Still Alice, for which Julianne Moore won an Academy Award, and American Honey, the official selection for the Festival de Cannes this year. She is making her directorial debut this year with Freak Show, and that stars Bette Midler, Abigail Breslin, Alex Lawther, and Laverne Cox. To present the Human Spirit Award this evening, I am very honored to introduce to you Miss Trudie Styler.
Hello, everyone. Well, I'm very delighted to be here tonight to present one of this year's Dusty Awards. And I'm full of admiration for all your achievements. And I know that your time at the SVA will have prepared you well to succeed. So when I was even younger than all of you, here's the granny speech beginning. My ambition was to become an actress, although at the time my planning left quite a lot to be desired. After a heated argument about my future with my dad, I ran away from home one May evening, actually, and went off to Stratford-upon-Avon in England, the home of the Royal Shakespeare Company. I was only 17, and as an aspiring actress, it seemed like the obvious and logical place to go. I hasten to add that I had no training yet, but at least I thought I was putting myself in the right place and at the right time. Well, it took a long time to repair the rift between me and my parents after I left, but happily with time, it did get healed. And despite their doubts, I did succeed. I've never been the kind of person to let obstacles get in the way, but I have to say that I owe thanks and tributes to many, many people who've helped me on my way, and tonight I'd like to pay particular tribute to the kind lady who answered the door that night to a bawling 17-year-old teenager who just said she'd left home to become an actress at the Royal Shakespeare Theatre. I trained at one of the great British drama schools and then in repertory theatres around the country when I later became one of the leading actresses at the Royal Shakespeare Company. And at that time, I was 25 and the circle was completed. In my life and career, as I said, I've met some extraordinary people, people who believe in themselves and in what they have to offer and who never give up. These are the people who make a difference in the world, and I've tried to learn from them. There are always challenges, but challenges are a gift. They focus the mind, crystallize goals, and give us the energy to succeed.
For coming here, I don't know any other school that does it like we do it. And therefore, I have to give really special, like Valerie did, special recognition to our Dusty producer, Annie Flocco, and her staff. They're just hardworking people. And to put this event together, which was a three or four day event, you know, it really does take hard work and organizing, and just they do a great job every year. So I can't be thankful enough to them. And Annie, I assume after tonight that you'll be almost done. You know, you have a day or two to wrap things up, whatever. And on another note, and this is a real honor for me, to have two dear friends of mine who are incredible, well-accomplished, proud alumni here tonight. It's Mr. Tom Cito, who is listed, he's done so many films, I suppose it's Jones and The Lion King and so forth, who is listed as one of the top 100 most important people in animation, you know? And a good friend. And he comes to SVA a lot, and when we go out to LA, he's a good buddy and talks to the students and so forth. So thank you, and your lovely wife, Patricia, who's the same way. You know, they actually fell in love at SVA, you know? So that was nice, right? And they're still together. So that's even nicer, right? And there's another person who he and I went to SVA together. And actually, Tom as well. So the three of us came together that year. But this gentleman, Oscar-winning sound man who won for Titanic, and he does most of what's his name? Quentin Tarantino's films. Yes, you know things. But he is revered. He's a revered and brilliant, I think, sound recordist. And these two guys are just incredible, and it's an honor to have them here tonight. And we are honoring them tonight, so that's pretty cool, you know. So, and finally, I want to leave you with this. That in all my experience, especially in acting, I have learned we are at our best in our art when we are open and vulnerable. That vulnerability never gets easier, and I can testify for that. But experience can give you confidence and make you still go forth. That is one of the reasons I believe in every filmmaker and every animator should spend some time discovering him or herself by taking an acting class. At SVA, we're very close to the acting community. Some of the students, particularly the film students, have to take an acting class. It's mandatory. And all those actors are from the actor's studio. And that's been a long relationship. So at the end of the day, a real art education is an education in yourself. The parts of you that can only discover your vulnerability and put it into your work is something that you just have to keep striving for. And don't be afraid, you know, of failure ever. Failure can make you stronger. So enjoy the night. See you later.
And I have a feeling that all of you who've worked so hard at what you love know what I mean. So I'm going to leave you with some words of Teddy Roosevelt, who said this very well. It's not the critic who counts. The credit belongs to the man or woman who's actually in the arena, whose face is marred by dust and sweat and blood, who comes short again and again because there is no effort without error and shortcoming, who spends himself in a worthy cause, who at the best knows in the end the triumph of high achievement, and who at the worst, if he fails, at least fails while doing greatly, so that his place shall never be with those cold and timid souls who neither know victory or defeat. So if I can leave you with one message tonight, it's this: never take no for an answer, never be overcome by failure, and never lose sight of your goals. And now to the real business of the night. I am delighted to present this year's SVA Human Spirit Award. And the award will go to Philippa Ford for her film Pippa.
Thank you. I just really want to thank my crew over there. I wish I could have brought them up with me. We went on this huge adventure, and it was just the journey of a lifetime. So thank you to SVA for letting me do this amazing project. And good luck to everyone else this evening. Thank you.
Philippa, wow. Trudie Styler gave you an award. I mean, this is, I'm thrilled. I'm fatumbled myself. Thank you, Ms. Trudie Styler. Give her another round of applause, please. Philippa, I have your card here, honey, with your name on it. I'll give it to you later. Don't worry. Okay. Okay. This year's Dusties continues with a relatively new award that we've started doing very recently. It recognizes our illustrious alumni. We have so many. And it's the Dusty Outstanding Alumni Awards, beginning with film. And our first alum attended SVA in the mid-70s and comes to us from a field that is a very, very important element in film, which is sound. And to present the award, we have to bring up the esteemed SVA faculty member who's worked in the film business for 50 years as a production sound mixer and teacher. Please welcome SVA's sound guru, Chris Newman. Chris? Yes, you're a guru. Come on up, Chris.
Gee, her font is bigger than mine. Mark Ulino was a classmate of Reeves, and it puts a lot more, much more pressure on me to do a really decent speech and intro. I'm so honored, delighted, to be able to